Hey, my name is Sean Cooper, the shyness and social anxiety guy, and I'm gonna make a bit of a shocking statement to you. You've been lied to by pretty much everyone. They've probably told you that in order to succeed in life, you need to put your head down, get to work, and eventually you'll get what you want. Now, if you're at least a few years out of university, you've probably looked around yourself and you've noticed that the people who actually seem to succeed, the people at your work who get that promotion that maybe you wanted, or the people who get the dates, or the people who just seem to have the most friends, they're not the people who work the hardest. They're definitely not the people who are the smartest or most intelligent. They're usually just the people who are the most well-liked. So if you came to this video thinking, "Why should I care if people like me?" Well, if you want to be able to make connections for your business or your work to get a promotion to make more money, or if you want to be able to maybe get more dates or get a girlfriend or boyfriend and make more friendships, then it makes sense to take a look at how you're coming across to people and see how you can tweak aspects of your personality so that other people like you more. And the good news is that you don't have to completely change your entire personality to become more likable to other people. I found that there's certain key things you can work on, small things in the way that you come across that make a huge impact. So in this video, I'm gonna cover one specific thing which I see pretty much anyone who is charismatic or well-liked doing. So what is it? Radiating warmth and positivity. The people who get promotions at their work, who make connections, who succeed in their dating life and have a good social life, what I've found is that pretty much all of them are able to radiate a warmth and a positivity to the people that they talk to. And a lot of people who have shyness or social anxiety, they're not able to have this warmth or positive energy, which means that it's a lot harder for you to get people's attention. You might be ignored more often. You might find it harder to make friends, or you say a comment and nobody laughs. Someone else says a comment and everyone seems to find it hilarious, even though you make the same comment. All these problems can be fixed if you can unblock your energy and learn to have more warmth in your personality. So in this video, I'll talk about a couple of different tips that can help you. The first thing that holds a lot of shy or socially anxious people back is the belief that people just suck. Back when I had really bad social anxiety, I remember I actually felt a lot of jealousy and hatred towards people. It's not just that I felt nervous around people, I actually didn't really like people, and often I wouldn't even find myself motivated to try to overcome my social anxiety because I just thought that pretty much every person I'd ever met was concerned with some stupid pop TV show, or all they talk about is gossiping about each other or about some celebrity. And when you think people suck, when you have some kind of bitterness or deep down hostility towards them, it's extremely difficult to have any type of warmth or positivity when you talk to them. So, can you even overcome this? Well, I'll share with you my experience. I found that back when I did feel that type of hatred and jealousy, I thought people sucked. A big reason for that was because I'd simply never had that many close personal relationships or that many good experiences with other people. I was kind of ignored, shut down. People subtly disrespected me. They didn't pay me any attention or try to be my friend. So that's part of what made me bitter and hostile. But as I learned to improve my social skills and I was able to meet people and form connections and have friendships and fun experiences, I started to see people in a different way. So before, when I thought people sucked, a big part of that is because I was viewing them from a distance in the abstract. You know, you turn on the news and you see that they talk about some stupid celebrity, or you see some dumb politician got elected who has such a narrow-minded opinion, right? And that's what you think people are like. But once you start to get to know people on a personal one-on-one level, you have positive experience with them. You go out with a friend to do something and you have a fun time. You share jokes, you laugh, you share stories, you create new stories even. And that type of experience can allow you to see that people aren't all that bad. And even those people who do sometimes watch like those stupid reality TV shows, even they can be fun to talk to once you actually get to know them. So I don't have any specific advice to get rid of your hostility or bitterness towards people if you have it. I'm just saying that maybe once you learn how to get to know people on a more one-on-one basis, that might go away on its own. Keep in mind that you don't need to be as social as like a social butterfly. You don't need to have like a million acquaintances if that's not your style, if that's not part of who you are. So the next thing that might hold you back from radiating warmth and positivity to other people is self-consciousness, or what I call self-monitoring. Now, the reason why I call this self-monitoring is if you have shyness or social anxiety, you probably realize that when you're around people, you suddenly become very, very painfully aware of every little thing you say and do. You know, before you say something, you might think about it in your head to see if it sounds okay. I remember back when I had really bad social anxiety, if I was shopping, I would reach up to grab something from the shelf in a store and I'd be so self-conscious of how my hand was moving. I looked very awkward just picking something up in a store if I saw that people were around me. So this type of self-consciousness or self-monitoring can definitely stop you from radiating warmth and positivity, because what you're doing is you're focusing on the wrong channel of communication. You're very focused on these little minute details in how you're coming across, like what angle is my hand going on? Is this word okay to say, or is that word better? But what you don't realize is that people rarely are focused on that channel of communication. People very, very rarely actually remember the specific words or sentences that you said. I mean, think about maybe a conversation that you had yesterday. Now, if you have shyness or social anxiety, you might not talk to people that often, so you might remember the conversation in great detail. But guess what? If that other person doesn't have shyness or social anxiety, they've probably had a bunch of different conversations yesterday, so they barely remember what you two talked about. They probably remember the general points or idea of what you said, but they're not gonna be able to remember specific sentences. So people rarely remember what you say or do, but they always remember how you made them feel. So if you want to learn how to radiate warmth and positivity, one of the best tips I can give you is to switch your focus onto this other channel of communication. So away from little minute behaviors, to focus on what energy you're emanating. So I recently traveled in South America for 3.5 months. I've mentioned this before. And while I was in South America, I decided to learn some Spanish. So for about 3 weeks, I took Spanish classes. So for about 4 hours each day, I'd go into a classroom and I'd have one-on-one Spanish lessons with a teacher. I can't talk it like completely fluently, but I could hold like basic practical type of conversations in Spanish. And not only did I have like that one-on-one lesson with a teacher, I also stayed in a house, a homestay. So after class, I would go to a local family's house and I would stay at their house and I'd eat dinner with them and we'd talk in Spanish. And from learning a whole new foreign language and practicing it so much, I found that this idea that we have this other energetic channel to our communication, that became very, very clear to me. I mean, even though when I was learning Spanish at first, I couldn't understand half the words that they were saying, I could always understand sort of what they meant. I could always understand if they were telling a joke or if what they were saying is supposed to be funny or if they were being serious. So if you want to sort of tune more into this other channel of communication, this emotional or energetic channel. Maybe go out to some place where people are talking, and instead of focusing on the words that they say, focus on the energy with which they say it, their tone of voice as they speak. You can even maybe go to a place where people are talking a different language, and that might actually make it easier for you to tune into this new channel of communication. And I can't stress how important this is. I was flirting with this girl and I teased her about something. And when you look at teasing, you know, a lot of girls find this to be very funny. You know, you tease a girl about something that she's wearing. You call her a nerd or a dork. And what is teasing? Teasing is basically making fun of someone, poking fun at them. So you're kind of being rude on the verbal channel, but you're doing it with a very warm and positive energy. Let's say you're a guy and you try to tease a girl, but you don't have that warm and positive energy. Well, she might just think you're a dick. It's not gonna work well. But as long as you have that warmer, positive energy, teasing can be very powerful with women. Or even, I see friends doing this to each other all the time. Back in high school, there's these two girls who had a very close friendship with each other. And, excuse my language, but they would call each other bitches all the time. And because they had a very close friendship, they had that rapport, and they said it in a funny, positive way, they didn't get offended at each other. In fact, it just deepened their friendship that they could call each other bitches and still get away with it. It has nothing to do with little specifics in what you're doing, how you're moving your hand or your body language or the words that you're saying. And it has everything to do with this underlying emotional current or energy that you're putting off. All right, so my last tip for learning how to radiate warmth and positive energy is figure out your inner blocks to expression. So this isn't something that I'm gonna be able to fix for you in this video, but I wanted to point out that when you have something like more severe shyness or social anxiety, you can often go into kind of a downward spiral that involves not just anxiety, but also depression. You feel like shit about yourself. You feel shamed about yourself. You don't accept yourself. You feel depressed about your life. And then you go on the internet and you search up articles and people just tell you, you know, just think positive or just be happy. And that type of advice doesn't work. If you have deeper blocks, you need to look at the root cause, not just trying to fix the symptoms by forcing yourself to feel happy. And oftentimes the root cause of feeling bad a lot of the time, or ashamed of yourself maybe, or depressed, is toxic shame. Your assumptions about yourself, about how people are. Maybe you anticipate that other people are going to be rejecting you, which is a type of assumption. These deeper causes of not being able to express positive or happy emotions. On the one hand, don't listen to that superficial advice like self-help motivational bullshit that tells you you just have to force yourself to be positive. But on the other hand, also, there's a lot of people who have social anxiety. They find out that there's a label for their problem, you know, social anxiety disorder, and they give up trying to improve. And then they go on the internet and they post comments telling other people that it's also not possible to improve. It's not true. You just need to find the right types of advice. I recorded a video called "Do You Feel Constantly Ashamed of Yourself?" And it talks about what one of these causes might be for you. It's called toxic shame. I'd encourage you to check that out. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope it gave you a couple of quick tips or pointers for how you also can maybe get the promotion at work that you want, or get more dates that allows you to get a girlfriend or boyfriend, or make more friends because other people see you as a more positive, warm person. They get a better energy off of you, which makes you more magnetic to other people. All right, so I'm Sean Cooper, the shyness and social anxiety guy, and I'll talk to you soon.